Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Benjamin Magnus Plays Hearts of Iron 4, Operation Never Get Involved in a Land War in Asia. Unless, of course, you're playing Hearts of Iron 4, in which case, it's cool, go for it. I was planning on last episode being my last one, but... So I did something just batshit crazy by declaring a land war against the Soviet Union when I have thousands and thousands and thousands of kilometers of border with them. Doesn't seem to fucking matter. Either way, the war is going perfectly fine. I mean, why don't we could probably actually use some... The only thing I, considering the fact I was basically just doing this for shits and giggles, I'm suffering from the fact that I don't have enough troops on the ground. I did lose 35 divisions, though. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, well... That's 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. Make a whole new army. Why not? I mean, I'm putting zero effort into this and still managed to, like, look at this. You can fight with tanks straight across the Caucasus Mountains. What is this? Sorry. Got a little carried away there. A little carried away. I mean, the Caucasus Mountains should pretty much be impenetrable for any sort of actual attacks. But Japanese tanks are full on fighting straight across the Caucasus Mountains. And not having the fucking slightest bit of trouble with it either. Weather doesn't really make any difference in the game. Terrain doesn't make any the slightest bit of difference. It really needs a lot of balancing. And like I was, I've been saying, I'm just this is at this point I'm not taking this seriously anymore. This is just for shits and giggles. I think it's funny that this goes back to Flanglist Poland. And the Ruskies got us tripped up at Odessa, it seems. What do the casualties look like? 1.26 million to 250,000, and I've got 20 million men. Oh, you know what? I downloaded a mod that gives you increased manpower for non-cord territory. And considering I control, like, a quarter of the world's population in non-core territory, that's where that came from. Like, look at this. The front, where we're just fighting straight across the Caucasus mountain range. Like, literally right over the mountains. Not even going around. Just straight up the center. Just mountain peaks. Having not the slightest bit of difficulty. So I'm assuming that we're not at war with these guys. Well, apparently we are. It's just nobody cares. Nobody seems to care. Like, the Soviet Union should be pouring across these borders. But they ain't. They ain't not doing it. Is that Nicaraguan, maybe? I like, El Salvador. I like how you can click on a unit and not get any information on it. I've said it before, I'll say it again. What I keep coming back to in my mind is the fact that EU4 was not a very good game when it first came out, but now it's phenomenal. Now it's astonishingly good. So the only thing what I keep coming back to is that it needs to mature. Just Americans? Yeah. It needs to mature. And as a Paradox game, that's what you gotta hope for. Is that the game's gonna mature and get better. Clearing up the border gore? Little bit. Never get involved in a land war in Asia unless you're playing Hearts of Iron 4. In which case, fuck it. Night Vision 2. Let's see here. Type 1, hokey. Type 1, ho-ha. Mechanize number 3. What could we get to help ourselves out? Why am I constantly singing? I don't know. Like I said, I'm kind of like delirious in my own like disdain right now. No, we're not even using our Air Force. Whoops. Everybody's got logistics companies. Let's do that. Supplies don't seem to really matter that much, though, considering you don't use IC to build them. Atomic research. Ooh, bombs. Why not? Although, I've heard that nukes are pretty much useless in themselves. Like, they don't do very much damage, and they don't do very much, Oh, Germany took Odessa. I don't know how Germany got control of the German Reich got control of that. Considering they don't have troops over here. Well, they do over here, but not over here. I mean, look at that. We really overran the Caucasus. Alright, where's all the Russian steel? Is there anything back here? Oh, there is! I could use another army. We got 4 tanks right here. We can add them to this army right here. That's these guys. Just add them in there. Like so. Got everybody on aggressive. It looks like they finally started moving. You know what I should do? Is let's take these guys and let's put them together. And they're gonna get a front line here, like this, I guess. So go get it. Transport them over here and go plug that gap. Do it, AI. Take care of it. Make me proud. Seriously, that's the most progress we're making. Actually, this front is actually really flying now. That Odessa was definitely a linchpin in the defenses, because now it's flying. Soviet tanks over here, T-34s. Well, it's a model T-34. I mean, we're all basically just like, ah, screw the Allies. They're not doing anything anyway. So we're gonna take this army, and right now their frontage ends right there. So if we extend it out, so like this. Wow. Apparently, there's basically no frontage that they're just like, no, we're not going to take care of. Alright, so we're gonna take Mongolia. Jesus Christ. Just draw a line and go. It's so stupid! There's no strategic gameplay to it whatsoever. It's like Production Simulator 2016. You just draw lines and let it go. How many? I wanted 24. I got 25, and there's a 20. Oh, there's 24 right there. I did it. I got it. So army and commander, and apparently you, because you're skill level 9. Front. Here, let's do this. You take to there. You, where did I have you end? Right there. So that means you can get, or not. Oh, there we go. Suck back to there, like that. And this guy, well, he can just come right back up here, because these guys are gonna, you guys are front line now. I think they're purple. So they can go like this. Oh, looks like I missed something. There we go. So apparently the Soviet Union did eventually figure out that they could just walk across the border and nobody was going to stop them. I like how sometimes you have to come over here and convince it that, yeah, you do need to attack. Alright, let's see here. We're up to 1.75 million dead. Although, you know, the Axis have suffered about 50% of that. Not me personally, but in total, about 50% of that, yeah. Mongolia. Oh, someone took it. Make sure they've got their improved anti-tank guns. Why the shit not? So let's see. These guys are gonna go like this, basically. And then, who is this? Which army? Is that this new one? I don't even know what's... I can't even tell what's going on over here anymore. Not that I'm paying that much attention. Oh, Riga fell. Actually, how close are... I mean, how many VPs have we actually taken? 16%. That's more than I expected, honestly. Armies are actually starting to merge... are gonna start merging together soon. I mean, like, right up here. What do we get? The Marblehead. We still got, or like this guy. Where is he? Have they made it here yet? Oh, they're going. They're making it to the front. The Marines are starting to filter into. Looks like most of them got sucked in up over here. I mean, definitely starting to slow down, but then again, it's not like we put a whole lot of forethought into this either. All right, we're starting to get to the positions where we're slowing them down over there. These fronts are gonna come together pretty soon. I wish Legionary Romania would clear up their borders, and I mean, the borders aren't gonna matter in the end because there's gonna be a peace conference when. Everything is said and done. There's Stalingrad right there. 30 victory points. How much is Leningrad worth? Another 30. Convoy sailing. What is this? Integrated convoy defense. Destroyer organization. Escort efficiency. blah, blah, blah. Or I don't even think we're making jet fighters right now. I haven't really been paying that much attention. Eh, why not? Type 61. Research it. What is going on in here? Can we just take these guys out so that we're not wasting time and resources? Keeping that pocket. So this is where these guys are set to go. Actually, let's delete that. All right, so White Army, why don't you have you stop doing whatever you're doing? Or is there still technically... All right, so there's that. All right, so let's see. What do we want to do here? Let's take the White Army, and we're going to give you a new offensive line. Because you're right up here, and you're going to... Basically, what you're going to do is this. Like that. And what we're actually going to do is move the focal point, like, that way. Like, from the top here. And scoot it up that way. So he's like, ah, go north. It's Siberia. That's where a dick it is. Go, go, go. And then there's this new blue army, or no, that's, where's that guy? This new light blue army. You're gonna have an offensive line that goes like here, and you're gonna take out Mongolia. And then who's the next one? Well, you go, yeah, that's fine. And purple army, you're gonna have an offensive line, like up this way like that. And go, 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 go gadget armies. And we'll clear all that up. I'm assuming. I mean, how did this happen? They got 4, 5, 6, 7 divisions stuck here. Hey, look at this. The armies are actually about to meet up. You, sir. Can you just roll into Stalingrad for me? I want to make sure I take that VP myself. Go. Boom. Stalingrad fell. That was a whole, like, 12%. We could probably actually lower our freaking conscription laws now. So this blue army stalled out. I mean, they got pretty close, but they definitely stalled out. And these guys... They just freaking opened up a hole, didn't they? Look at that. Alright, let's just make sure everybody's... doing their thing. Let's get this... Let's keep this going. I mean... Like I was saying, I'm just doing this for poops and giggles, because I want to see what happens. Wasn't planning on continuing the series, but we'll keep going and see how this goes. I'm thinking what's going to happen is, because most of the VPs are over here, that Germany is going to end up getting most of the war score. Stalingrad fell? How did we lose Stalingrad? Go. Basically, I'm gonna tell these guys to rush up there and grab VPs. And this army... Let's see. Go like this. Make sure he comes up this way. That. Let's try to get him from the other direction as well. Make sure they're doing their thing. I feel like I've caused most of the casualties because I have most of the frontage. You seriously didn't? My God. How difficult is it? Come on, really? How the shit difficulty? Come on. You can write a better AI than this. It doesn't have anything in its script that says attacking from multiple directions is preferable. It doesn't have anything to tell it to do that. You saw it at Odessa too. It's just like, nah, we're cool. What is this? Flangelist Poland again. Oh, it looks like it dropped off to Germany and then went back to Flangelist Poland. I don't think there's many people in here. Two divisions now. Starting to capture factories. Go gadget Japanese army of doom. It's pretty summy. It's not a very big army, considering the amount of territory I own. Oh, the Germans flooded into these positions now. Look at the frontage moving. It's just attacks and attacks and attacks and attacks. Soviet Union's kind of a paper tiger in this game, the way it's balanced right now. Maybe I should play Soviet Union next, because they always seem to lose. They never have any allies, and they always lose. How did you do that? How did you do that, Germany? How did you get guys over there? It doesn't seem to really make any difference. Again, fighting in Scandinavia is fierce. Fierce Scandinavian fights. And nothing has happened. Is Italy not in this? No, they are. Can I ask Germany for control of any states yet? Give me everything you own. All right, we're starting to make some. Yeah, we're making progress. I mean, these guys are all super inexperienced, but they'll get their fill killing communist soldiers. What is that? Port strike? Oh, about 100 Mexican planes attacked our carrier group. 100. Well, we shot down 100 Mexican planes and lost one bomber. Even this front is moving up. I think it's because they're having to pull troops off of it to reinforce other ones. Mongolia's gotten pretty overrun. And we are making progress up here. Got any new troops over here? One tank division. Blah. What are we missing? Artie, wow. Let's let them train. Are we not building enough, or do we just not have enough? We're not building it. Well, we did build an entire army, and then another entire army. Look at that. Look at that. I mean, seriously, when you run into a mountain range, you should suffer like 90-95% reduction in attacking potential. For attacking into a mountain range, something a lot. It's not balanced, right? It's weird. Nobody can tell me that I should be able to drive Japanese tanks across the Caucasus Mountains from the south and make it through there perfectly fine. Nobody should tell me that that's balanced, right? Why are you guys not doing anything? These guys are paper tigers. They got nothing. Attack them. Everywhere. On every front. There we go. Go! Go, go, gadget. Japanese everything. And technically, right now, Legionary Romania and Germany is getting all this land, but it'll all be signed over in the peace deal based on war score Mongolia's capitulated. Well, that makes things easy for me. Done it. Who'd we get? Another carrier. Oh, the carrier was sunk, the Ranger. Well, not the original Ranger, it was a modern Ranger. Alright, let's see what we got. Look, what are we looking at now? We are looking at 41% capitulation. Controls 62, it controls 62%, 59% of its VPs. So why is this not going to continue any further? We're gonna... Which order is that? Whose order is that? Is that one of my guys? You better not be... No, that's not one of my guys. So you better not have an order to do that. Think we'll be able to beat the Soviet Union with basically little to no effort? Because I do. Hey, Moscow, we're creeping up on Moscow. I took Stalingrad myself, but I mean, we haven't made it much further past there on our accord. It's weird that the front went from north to south, from north to south to east to west pretty significantly. Let's see, let's just... let's wait for them to deploy. I mean, they're close. And let's make sure that we... make sure that they stop after that one. I mean, this is just ridiculous, don't you think? I assume that when I declared war on the Soviet Union, the Axis was going to really clear up the border war, and that everything would be absolute chaos. Absolute chaos. A little bit less chaos than I anticipated. That's why, well, that's a significant number of troops right there. That's 13, that's 17 divisions we're about to encircle and destroy. Apparently, we just decided we're going to go around that one. I forgot about that. Anybody else forget about that? Pause. Where is this? Oh, down here in Plymouth. Cornwall! Cornwall is rebelled, guys. Cornwall is the seat of... of chaos in England. I forgot about that. Holy shit. They've got... Oh, there's another one over there, too. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 divisions. They're doomed. And this is the Free States of America. They're a little stronger. That's a little more interesting. Free States of America. All right, so Stalingrad's fallen, Mongolia's fallen. Probably hundreds of thousands of the British Empire collapsed. They only had the one VP, and there was, like, 40 divisions of allies in it. I mean, we're going to keep this series going just because of how crazy it is. If you have enjoyed this episode, everybody, just drop me a like, leave me those comments right down below. And if you're interested in more Benjamin Magnus Plays Hearts of Iron 4, just subscribe to this channel, and I'll see you next time.